Version 8.15 of the GeoStudio product suite has just been released. This new version includes the addition and improvement of features to the existing product suite. GeoStudio now offers full support for partial factor analysis in Slope W. This improvement will allow the ultimate limit state to be analyzed in accordance with various limit state design approaches, such as Eurocode 7, Norwegian Standard 3480, and British Standard 8006. Partial factors can be applied to characteristic loads and soil strength parameters. The calculated factor of safety should be interpreted as an over-design factor. All GeoStudio products have a new user interface in the Draw Materials window. First, we will see that in this example, the top region in multiple analyses does not have a material assigned. When the Draw Materials window is opened, you as a user can now add a material legend to indicate the materials applied to the model domain for visualization purposes. The Apply to All Analyses option also enables you to apply a material in one analysis and have that material be applied to that particular region in all analyses in the analysis tree. Another new feature available in all GeoStudio products is the ability to add dimensional objects to the drawing. By choosing Sketch Dimensions, the length of the drawn section will be added to the drawing as a visualization tool by simply clicking on the beginning and end point of interest and dragging the dimension drawing above or below the line. You can also change the color of the dimension drawing by changing the color prior to drawing the dimension. In the results view of the Slope W product, some new features and improvements have been added to help visualize the slope stability solution. Under Draw Slip Surface Results, the safety map can be added and modified in the new Slip Surface Results window. The safety map also now features the factor of safety contours indicating the levels of factor of safety. You as a user can now also view all slip surfaces in the Slip Surface window with contour shading related to this resulting factor of safety value. The legend showing the range of these contours can also be added to the background of the window for visualization purposes. These contours are also present on the grid, which can be toggled off and on in this window. The contours can be changed similar to the Draw Contours option, with the range entered manually or automatically. The slip surfaces viewed on the screen can be changed via a new filter in the Slip Surface window. This filter can be applied to only valid slip surfaces, only invalid slip surfaces, only a specified number of slip surfaces with the lowest factor of safety results, or simply those surfaces within a range of factor of safety values. Another new feature in the Slope W product is the Select Slip Surface command that allows you as a user to select a slip surface either by choosing a point in the grid or choosing the slip surface directly along the model domain while this command is active. Also note the new tooltip information available while using the Select Slip Surface command. This information includes the coordinate information, slip surface number, and factor of safety result. When any drawing feature is active, a new coordinate system can be used to add points, lines, or regions to the view window. These features allow you as a user to add points simply by typing in the desired coordinates, using the At button with the length in the X and Y directions, using Ctrl Z on your keyboard or the Undo button to undo a region point, using Ctrl Y or the Redo button to redraw the region point, using the at sign to give the dimension length and the less than sign to draw an angle. Also note, Here, the new information given on the cursor tool tip, with the coordinate information, length, and angle from the previous point, and offset information from the previous point. You can also choose to simply use a point command, such as P1, to draw a line to point 1, which will finish my region here. There is an additional option to the region openings called the polygonal opening. This opening works in a similar manner to the circular opening command, but allows you as a user to decide on the shape and size of the polygon by using your mouse or the new keyboard input coordinate options. Another new exciting feature is the ability to split regions into multiple separate regions. You can start the line for the split on either side of the desired region or regions and create multiple regions over the same model domain. If instead a single region is desired, the new Merge Regions command can be used to join regions together into a single region. Materials can now be copied across GeoStudio files by simply using the copy and paste commands. In two separate GeoStudio files, a material can be copied from one file to another, with all of the individual functions and input parameters being copied to the new file. Other features and improvements in the 8.15 release include the ability to import regions and images from AutoCAD drawing files for both DWG and DXF files, as well as other GeoStudio files, the ability to conduct probability and sensitivity analysis on reinforcement in slope W, and support for remote desktop users for all license types. Thank you for watching.